So please give it up for James's advance 3 class.
Advance 3, also known as Womb Adjacent. We're going to do a slacker for you, which is long form. You'll figure out what that is in a second. It's the common link is the character. So you'll see. All we need to get started is a line of dialogue. What's something someone said to you today? I have a specific set of skills.
Did you see that?
I'm in the wrong place.
They were crafting and crafting. I would hope so. The crochet Olympics isn't for babies.
I don't take this lightly, Deborah. I've been preparing for months.
Months? Becky? I was crocheting in the womb.
Sounds painful and impossible.
My mom has some scars, yeah. Yeah, it's dark. That's what this is about. It's not just all baby blankets and tying socks, okay?
All I've been working on is baby blankets and tying socks.
Yep. You looked like one.
So did you get the job or what?
No.
I knew you wouldn't, I.
Aurelia!
I didn't want you to leave, so I sabotaged you.
You lived up to that.
I don't want you to leave.
But I need to make money.
I'm so torn.
Crocheting was the only shot you had.
So she didn't go, right?
Yeah, she didn't.
Everything worked the way we expected.
That's right. She's going to stay in Nebraska, and she's going to stay with me.
Oh, I thought you were going to stay with me in Nebraska.
I am staying with you in Nebraska, but I have lied to her so I can stay with you.
This is being so exciting that we finally start our lives together in Nebraska.
I always wanted to raise turnips. I love having a double life.
Yes?
I have 3 lives and a drinking
problem. 3?
That's the music box I had as a child.
Patrick? I don't care how many lives I have. I miss you for all these years. Your music's missed.
So the music box just exploded in his face? I haven't turned it on in 20 years. I didn't know.
Well, I guess it's expected. I mean, you should get those things checked. So how's he doing now?
He's dead. Oh! No. I just found him and I lost him. We just can't take anything for granted this
world. Yeah, I mean, someone's got to tell his wives.
Not me, not this time.
I was the one that told him last time, remember?
I have a personal connection to this man. He died in my arms. He reached up and he smeared his blood all over my face, and I'm still seeing a therapist for that. Now you want me to go see his double, triple life?
Why should I get involved in all of this?
he just like never came to Nebraska. You know where he might be.
I buried him underneath the old sycamore tree.
The sycamore tree?
The one in my yard. I don't know where you live, but I'm not really comfortable telling you.
We need closure. Please, have a heart. I'm the second wife of a man who just left me in Nebraska.
Please, have a heart. You see that tree about 3 blocks down? That's my house.
Can you... I'm so lonely. I haven't talked to anyone since I moved to Nebraska.
I shouldn't, but I feel a real connection to you. Let's walk together. I think you've got some real potential here.
Max. So, how's the new job, Anita?
It's fine, they call me Daryl.
Peculiar, but you know, corporate America just makes no sense. I mean, if you gotta be Daryl to get a paycheck, I guess you're Daryl.
Yeah. Just like in school when they call me Bob, so it doesn't really, you know.
That was more of a coping mechanism for all the children. It just, you startled them when you walked in.
I know, it's the face.
It's the face, and you got a lot of limbs. The extra ear.
Ears or limbs?
Yeah.
All right.
Why not? You can hear out of it. It's basically a limb.
Yeah, all right. Feel good about Optimus, you know?
Yeah. Your boss kind of looks a little creepy.
He's super creepy.
I saw him at the trailer park the other day. Not the trailer park part being creepy, just he had like a lot of chickens running around.
Are you at the trailer park with the two chasing a bunch of chickens?
That's where mommy's hog dealer lives. Mommy's got to keep even.
It's going to be 120.
Francois, we do this every time. Come on. It's Christmas.
You know I love haggling, though.
I know. Francois, how about I give you some home-baked cookies instead? No, just normal ones. They're taken base. I didn't even make them.
All right. You know how I love Christmas in the spirit. Take it. Get out of my life.
Not even in a bag or anything?
No, it's on a stick. You know I love looking into your eyes.
It's wow. I am a married woman. I have a child.
You don't have a degree from Harvard?
I could pretend I did. That helped.
It does.
Yeah. Yeah. I'm a lawyer. My name's L. Woods.
My trailer is a 12-bedroom mansion.
Francois!
So I heard that the trailer with all the chickens is where I could get a big giant bag of free beef.
That was last week. It was last week. Unless you're a 40-year-old MILF, I can't help you.
Thanks. I'll come back to share. I have to work out there. I know I have skills.
Tie yourself up.
Okay. Dad.
Get back into it.
Dad, get my arms. Dad.
That's right. Call me Dad now. I know. I made you blind to gender and the rules have been assigned, but perhaps I did too good of a job.
It was so hard, it's like, I couldn't recognize a condition's attraction, because I'm like, what is it really? You know? What's a mom and what's a dad really?
Well, I just realized that 7 degrees of crochet, everything leads to crochet, man. Religion, birthdays, words. I just could not let you.
Like McDonald's of the stuff he's not. Like, they don't care about crochet. It's like 2 pieces of yarn, like 3 pieces of string. They don't care.
You do not need to work for Christmas. You do not need to leave ever again.
Glenda, I'm here to repossess the house. If you just can't afford it, what you make. The Max is taking it back.
Have mercy.
If only you had a marketable skill like crochet.
I can get the money.
By tomorrow at midnight?
I'm that good. Hey, Mark.
That's my
You're
name.
A real asshole.
That's what the corporate world does to you. If you're not an asshole, you get ground down in dust.
Good luck with your second wife.
I don't need luck. I've got money.
Soon I do, too.
Here to give you those staples and apps for your belongings.
Kind of
joke? No.
Damn.
No.
Why?
Because I don't like you. You stole my job.
Did
you
steal it? Okay, stole it.
You stole it. You did steal it.
Okay, so to make up for it.
You're gonna apologize.
I'm gonna give you these staples and take your belongings.
And apologize.
Really sorry that I have to take your belongings.
Alright. Well, come on in, yeah.
Okay, so.
Help yourself.
Anything of value, specifically? Alright, so.
Yeah, just help yourself. Don't watch your back, you know. You know, I meant lifting, it's not like I was gonna, you know.
Okay.
I'm gonna put these with my other staples.
Okay. You know, they promoted me. We merged with Remax. So, I got this gig.
Great.
This.
Yeah, for you.
Thank you. Appreciate that original theory.
Thanks.
So, I'm going to take your stereo. Yep.
Come to this bridge to jump to.
Yeah, I took all my stuff. I took all my stuff, so I just set my own house on fire and I locked her inside. And I just ran to the nearest bridge. What happened to you?
I'm so sorry, old Daryl. I got a habit of power. I know you.
It's been so long. You look so different.
Tattered. I've been brown now. I have been a hobo.
Life's so hard.
When I was growing up, nobody told me I'd have to.
You guys come to the bridge to jump to? We're the CEOs of OfficeMax and Remax, respectively. We've made horrible business decisions. Now insurance suits. Daryl was killed in the line of duty. So he came after us. We got nothing now. I may be a corporate shill, but I remember one of my employees. That's old Daryl.
Me.
Hey. It's like, are you all about second chances? Multiple lives and gender mix-ups? What I'm saying is, do you want a second chance? And do you want a first chance, mysterious stranger who's supposed to kill himself?
No, we can all take new identities. We can be new people.
I love to have a second chance and a first chance.
I want a fourth chance and a fifth chance.
All right, while we're on the outside of this bridge, you know, pressure makes the best thinking. Let's come up with a business plan right now. And if we can't think of one in 5 minutes, we're going to jump. Oh, perfect. Thank you.
You guys do life insurance. Let's push them off the bridge.
Office Max, Remax.
Who wants to
Oh, my God.
You said think quick.
I don't want it for murder.
I didn't think that far ahead.
Old Daryl.
Blame him. He's had four chances.
Thomas Office Max. This from you.
I moved to Nebraska.
Well, my 5 minutes is about up. Do you have a business plan that's going to make billions of dollars?
No, I don't. What was he asking about the business plan for?
Something about being wanted for murder, multiple murders, identity changes. Burning people alive in homes. Nothing important, really.
I suddenly feel alright again.
Hey, what are you doing tonight?
What do we got here?
Woo! Fun! Hey, welcome.
Welcome.
I made some cookies around the corner over there.
That's right, man. You know I've got my drug test tomorrow.
Well, you're not smoking, Mama's smoking. You're by yourself over there. Alone in your little sober corner. Be lonely.
No. This is my birthday. It isn't about you.
Sweetheart, 21 years ago, who brought you into this world?
You bring it every time.
Yeah. Because you always say, this is my day. And yet I remember 32 hours of labor. And then your ass comes into the world as the biggest day of my life because I was done pushing your chunky head. You know I never asked for
something. I know you scream at me every year on my birthday.
Well, again, 32 hours of labor. I'm used to screaming this time of year, I suppose.
I can always have friends. Alcoholic, 21-year-old.
I recognize that head anywhere. I delivered you 21 years ago.
Hey, doctor,
it was the easiest childbirth I'd ever seen anyone
do. Are you kidding me, Dr. Stone?
Less than 30 seconds, and you just popped right out. Right into my waiting arms. You were so beautiful.
I need some kind of proof, because my mom is an Italian now. Typically, every year, 21 years. She shames me in front of my friends. I shame eat.
You don't believe me.
I'm ambivalent at this point. Afflicted.
You look like you've been through a lot, Jack.
I've been through a lot.
Come on back to my basement and I'll show you this. I take all the childbirths in
the Hey, happy birthday!
Oh my god!
First of 21 shots. I heard about this guy on his 21st birthday. 21 shots, okay? Then I think he got alcohol poisoning and died.
So I would want to do this today on my birthday. You were trying to kill me on my birthday.
No.
Oh, okay.
But seems we're gonna die trying, right? I'm gonna finish this one off.
And she's like, bring in friends. So far, you know, I wasn't showing up. You know, weird doctor. My mom's screaming about how painful and torn up she is.
I made a Facebook group, but no one's RSVP yet.
Same thing every year. Where's your weird friend?
Well, we waited for you for like 15 minutes. We left because I felt like such a loser.
Is it birthday?
Yeah. Do you think my mom and dad's basement wasn't a good location?
For 21st birthday?
No. It was built in a bar when they redid the basement in 1979.
Thank you.